Cubs manager Joe Maddon said Yu Darvish and that triceps issue in the bullpen session on Thursday, quote, did not go well. He's been sent back to Chicago to be reevaluated. Darvish admitted after Monday's rehab start, his right tricep still didn't feel 100%, felt more pain when he tried to extend it on Thursday. So, Jim Bowden, with the news of Yu Darvish, a guy that they paid a lot of money in the offseason to bring to Chicago, what does this do to Theo Epstein and this team right now?
I mean, obviously it's devastating, and I think when you see this bullpen setback, what it means is you're not going to see him in July no matter what, because by the time you get going, it takes a couple of weeks. And I think when you're Theo Epstein, Jed Hoyer, and Joe Maddon, you've got to look at this injury and say, okay, maybe we get him back in August, maybe we get him back in September, but if you want to win this division, if you want to hold off the Cardinals and the Brewers, you're going to have to fix this problem. And fixing it means you're going to have to go to the trade market. Let's take a look on this graphic here on exactly how their starting rotation has been so far. At the top of the rotation has been really good. John Lester having one of his better seasons, 10 wins, a 2-1 ERA. None of us should be surprised with that. Kyle Hendricks, Jose Quintana, both pitching well. Both should have better second halves, giving up 4 runs per 9 innings. But it's the back of the bullpen that's a concern. Mike Montgomery has done well in this role, filling in, but his best spot is probably in the bullpen. Tyler Chatwood has a ridiculous 1.7 whip this year. He's walked way too many hitters. His ERA is too high. And so what they need to do to fix it is go to the trade market. Now, they don't need to go chase a Jacob deGrom. They don't have to go chase a Blake Snell. What they need to do is go after a rental. And there are two rentals that are available on the trade market right now. Jay Happ of the Toronto Blue Jays, Cole Hamels of the Texas Rangers. Both are free agents at the end of the year. The Cubs have enough prospects in the system to make a deal for one of these two guys. Now look at these two guys. Interestingly, they both have pitched about the same, 97 innings for Happ, 97 a third for Hamels. Look at their ERAs.
Exactly.
Almost
the same.
Identical.
Yeah, pretty much.
Amazing. So you don't worry about the one guy's 10-3, one guy's 4-6. You can offset that by saying Cole Hamels has a better postseason record, and that could be a difference. If you can get either one, you slot him in the fourth spot in the rotation. If Darvish doesn't come back, you're all set. If he does come back, look how deep and strong your rotation is. But I think they need to fix this. I don't think they can keep pitching with what they have.
You said either one would be just fine, but if you had your druthers between Happ or Hamels, who would you like?
I would take Happ right now. I'm a little bit worried about Hamels. He's a little bit in decline here. I think he would step it up if he got in a pennant race with the Cubs, but I feel a lot better about Happ. This guy really works fast, changes speeds, fills up the strike zone. I think it's a better fit.
That's the front office fix for the Cubs. Happ or Hamels, we'll have to wait and see.